Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. This is Vin to chat room. Metal Gear Solid 3. This will be my first time playing this, guys. So I just want to say I'm excited for this. And I've been dying to play this game for many years. But before I start streaming it, first I want to just say hello, everyone. It's good to see you all. And I'm excited to finally be streaming Metal Gear Solid 3. I have the Xbox version because this is the one. I don't have a PS3 or a PS4, so I had to buy the HD collection on the Xbox. And I figured it would be better to do it this way than to do it through the 3DS version, which has frame rate problems and various other things. Peace Walker is on disc 2. I probably won't be streaming Peace Walker, but I might check it out at some point. Let me tell you guys a little bit about my history with the Metal Gear franchise. Metal Gear Solid 1 blew me away. I played it when it first came out. Got it for Christmas, so almost when it first came out. And I loved it. I beat it multiple times, including on the hardest difficulty. I love that game. The music, the story. The story was so good. The characters were so cool. I probably would put that in one of my top games of all time. I love Metal Gear Solid. I've played Twin Snakes, which is the GameCube remake, and the original Metal Gear Solid, the PlayStation version. Both of them I've streamed over the past 5 years that the site has been around. So I've played through those, and somewhat recently. Metal Gear Solid 2, I enjoyed. When I was younger, I liked it a lot more. Probably completed it twice. I remember some of its story, not all of it. But I definitely loved Metal Gear Solid 2, just not as much as 1. And I've never streamed it, but I have watched it, you know, be streamed within the past few years. So I kind of have an idea of what the story was. Metal Gear Solid 3, for some reason, you know, I didn't have money when it first came out to buy it. And there were other things going on in my life at the time, if I remember correctly. And then I remember asking for it for Christmas, and my parents couldn't find it. So I just kind of let it just fade. And then there was a few occasions where I was actually at a GameStop, and I was like, hey, do you have Metal Gear Solid 3? Nah, man, we're fresh out. And it was like weird. Fate just kept me away from this game. I just kept forgetting about it, and I kept, I kept kind of letting it just disappear. And also too, you know, I was more interested in Solid Snake's story. I knew this one took place in the 60s. So I was kind of like, well, I want a continuation of the story. So in some ways I just kind of let my brain forget about the game and nothing ever happened with it. And then the 3DS remake was going to be the one that I was going to get. I was so excited for it because I was like, oh, I can play this. And then if I get the 3DS capture, this was before I had the capture card, I was like, I can stream Metal Gear Solid 3 from the 3DS. It's going to be awesome. And then I played the demo. And the frame rates were bad. The controls were weird. And I got some not so great reviews saying that it had some good features, but it was not the best version of the game. And again, Metal Gear Solid 3 slipped through my fingers until finally I realized Final Fantasy VII will be over. What am I streaming after that? And there were some recommendations, some suggestions, and KY in particular, I remember, was saying, you got to play Metal Gear Solid 3. And he was like, you should stream it. And that wasn't even, he wasn't even the main reason, but he reminded me that that was a great idea. And so I went to the store and I bought the HD edition. And now here we are, finally. Years later, I still have not played Metal Gear Solid 3. I've not played Metal Gear Solid 4. I've missed a lot of the franchise, and it's nice to be able to jump back in a little bit. I will tell you, I've played the Game Boy version. I've completed it. the Game Boy Metal Gear, which I actually thought was really good. And I've played VR missions to completion as well. So I have played quite a few Metal Gear Solid games. Metal Gear 1 and 2 I never played, though. I didn't play those. So I've played a few, but I've missed a lot. So let's not drag this out any further, I guess. All right, 1964, Virtuous Mission and Operation Snake Eater. The origin of the Metal Gear series begins in 1964 at the height of the Cold War. Naked Snake, the man who would later become the legendary soldier known as Big Boss, heads into Soviet territory. Hang on a second. There we go. Heads into Soviet territory to help the scientist Sokolov defect to the West. However, the mission ends in failure when Snake's mentor, a female soldier known as the Boss, unexpectedly defects to the Soviet Union. Wait, is this all the story? What's going on here? The fate of the world hanging in the balance. Snake is forced to question the true meaning of loyalty as he embarks on a lone mission to kill his former mentor. Oh. So, people who are really good at this game, there have been people in chat that have showed up and were like, oh, I'm going to get so pissed at this playthrough. Please just keep it to yourself. Don't ruin this. You know, listen, I'm not going to be good at this game. I'm going to fuck up a lot. I'm going to get caught a lot. I don't remember all the mechanics from Metal Gear, and I'm not overly amazing at video games to begin with, but I will do my very best. And if my playing of this game annoys you, you are not forced to stay. It's just the full Metal Gear. Oh my god, look at this. Well, I guess we gotta play these first, huh? Hey, I remember this music. They use this for the VR missions. I thought that was a ghost down there. This is Big Boss, Operation Intrude, N13. Or 313, infiltrate the enemy's base, Outer Heaven. Wow, Metal Gear Solid 3 looks a lot worse than I thought it would. Alright, yeah, you know I'm not gonna be doing this. That's just not gonna happen. Let's actually begin Metal Gear Solid 3, and that way I don't have to play, I could just watch cutscenes for 5 hours. Fox. Blood. Get that off. It's horrible. Camera mode. Third person. Camera up and down. Reverse. That's just how I play. Sorry. People will find any reason to get upset with me, and that is one of them. They're like, oh, Vinny Scrub Tier doesn't use reverse? Reverse? I don't know. I just got used to it, man. What is that? What is this? What are these options? Playing the Metal Gear series. I'm not playing this for the first time, but I like one better than I like two. What does this change? Vinny, pick two. Pick two. All right. Difficulty, standard difficulty level. Let's do normal. Pick three because you get camos and stuff. All right. Well, I picked two already, so.
After the end of World War II.
Yeah, David Hayter.
Split into two. East and West.
Two.
This marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
Oh, yeah. David Hayter. I love his voice acting. This is exciting. Salute Hideo Kojima. You can't see it, but I'm actually saluting the screen right now, guys.
Dagestan, altitude 30,000 feet.
Approaching Soviet airspace.
20 minutes to drop off.
Commencing internal depressurization. Equipment check. Arm main parachute.
All right. You ready to go?
Drop zone still showing a high pressure mass. Cap okay.
Looks like he's been staring into the sun.
High visibility.
Yeah, I mean, for everyone else, but I mean, when you look at the sun intently, you tend to look like that.
Put out that cigar. Connecting oxygen hose to interior connector. Put on your mask.
Is that right?
Does this panty waist know what he's doing?
Approaching release point.
Panty waist?
10 minutes to drop off.
Hey, are you deaf?
He said put out the cigar and put on your mask.
Right. Throw the cigar. Slow the camera down.
Depressurization complete.
Checking oxygen supply.
6 minutes to drop off. Opening rear hatch.
Sunrise.
I know someone who wants to look at that sunrise.
External temperature, minus 46 degrees Celsius. 2 minutes to drop off. Stand up.
This jacket is moving on its own. Get it off! Get it off me!
You'll be falling at 130 miles per hour. Try not to get frostbite from the windshield.
1 minute to drop off. Move to the rear.
Activate the alarm.
Yeah, let me try to make my skin.
The world's first halo jump.
Let me make my skin more resistant to fucking freezing cold temperature.
Status okay.
Maybe you should have gave me a better suit.
Prepare for drop off. Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Spread your wings
and fly. God be with you.
Definitely gonna find some people who just don't give a shit, you know, to do stuff like this. Like, this is not a guy who has anything like a stamp collection back home that he really wants to see again.
Jack, I've got some important news. The head of the CIA has finally given us the green light for the virtuous mission.
Virtual mission?
No, the virtuous mission. The future of our Fox unit depends on it. If it succeeds, we'll be officially organized into a unit.
Virtuous mission. Sounds like some kind of initiation ritual.
You know, don't get cocky. This isn't a training op.
Right.
These inflections.
So what exactly is this wonderful mission?
David Hayter inflections.
About 2 years ago, a certain Soviet scientist requested asylum in the West through one of our moles. His name is Nikolai Stepanovich Sokolov.
What a bitch.
Head of the OKB-754 son of a bitch, Sokolov. Bureau, one of the Soviet's top secret weapon research facilities. And the East's foremost expert on weapons development.
Sokolov? Isn't he that famous rocket scientist?
The very same. On April the 12th, 1961, the Soviets achieved the first manned spaceflight in history.
I mean,
the Earth was blue, but there was no God.
It's probably thousand other cosmonauts that were killed
the
in orbit.
That carried Yuri Gagarin to orbit was the A-1.
Yeah, that's the first one we know about.
Sokolov is said to
Google
be
the lost cosmonaut theory
for the multi-engine cluster used in that rocket. After Gagarin's flight, Sokolov left rocket development to become the head of the newly established design bureau.
From a lowly technician to head of a design bureau, that's quite a success story. So why do you want to defect?
It seems he'd become afraid of his own creations.
Afraid?
Call it a crisis of conscience.
And for that, he left his country and his family behind and went over the fence?
Not exactly. One of his conditions was that his family was also to be taken safely to the West. who used a mole to get the family out first and succeeded in sneaking Sokolov over the Berlin Wall shortly afterwards. I was the one who conducted the operation.
The security on the eastern side was still full of holes back then. Then what?
We got Sokolov over in one piece, but the whole ordeal
David Hayter's voice.
Exhausted, and we checked him into a hospital in West Berlin. It took him 2 weeks and more than 600 miles to get from the research facility in the Soviet Union to Berlin. He was in no condition to say anything coherent. And it was only a week later that we had something much bigger on our hands.
Is that real footage?
The Cuban Missile Crisis.
October the 16th, 1962. President Kennedy received word that the Soviets were in the process of deploying intermediate-range ballistic missiles in Cuba. The president demanded that the Soviets dismantle and remove the missiles. At the same time, he announced a naval blockade to prevent further missile shipments from reaching Cuba. But the Soviets didn't back down, instead placing their armed forces on secondary alert. Soviet transport ships carrying missiles continued on course towards Cuba. U.S. and Soviet forces went on alert for an all-out nuclear war. Frantic negotiations were conducted through the UN's Emergency Security Council and unofficial channels to end the hair-trigger standoff. Finally, on October the 28th, the Soviet Union agreed to remove its missiles from Cuba.
And so that was almost the end of the world. Holocaust.
But in order to get the Soviets to pull their missiles out, we had to make a deal.
You mean the one where the U.S. agreed to remove its IRBMs from Turkey?
No. The Jupiter IRBMs deployed in Turkey were obsolete, and we were going to get rid of them anyway. They had no strategic value whatsoever to either the U.S. or the Russians. The Turkey deal was a ruse, a cover story that was fed to the other intelligence agencies around the world.
So what did the Russians really want?
Sokolov.
AIDS. Oh, sorry.
They wanted us to return Sokolov.
You mean the Soviets pulled out of Cuba just to get their hands on Sokolov?
That's right.
What the hell was he working on?
At the time, we had no idea. We were running out of time. It was either give up Sokolov or risk full-scale nuclear war. In the end, we had no choice. President Kennedy gave in to Khrushchev's demand. The next day, I got Sokolov out of the hospital, handing him over to agents on the eastern side. Sokolov kept on screaming, "Save me," until he disappeared from my sight. Then a month ago, we received some new information from one of our moles.
About Sokolov?
Yes. He was taken back to the research facility and forced to continue working on the weapon in question under KGB supervision. What's more, it's on the verge of completion.
So what kind of weapon is it? Something to do with space rockets?
No. Missiles.
Same technology.
I guess you're right. We don't know the details, but it appears to be a new kind of nuclear device. For half a year now, the Soviets have been conducting frequent nuclear tests at Semipalatinsk.
Something to do with the weapon, I assume.
We're talking about a secret weapon so big that Khrushchev was ready to pull out of Cuba to get it back.
Is Sokolov still in the facility?
No. According to our intelligence, he's in Selenoyarsk, a place in the mountains about 3 miles to the west that's known as the Virgin Cliffs.
The Virgin Cliffs. Nice name for a virtuous mission.
They moved him there just recently.
Why?
Apparently,
mission.
They're conducting a field test of the weapon, but it's our best chance to get him back. This mission would never have been possible if he was still in the research facility. This is our last chance.
Sokolov
must have known that too when he contacted us.
But M, when will I get my BMW? My Aston Martin? Press R to fall at better speed. Whoa, I can zoom in with R,
listen
actually.
Up, Jack. Your mission is to infiltrate Selenoyarsk in the Soviet mountains, ensure the safety of Sokolov, and bring him back to the west.
Wait. I can look through the mask with RB.
If we don't get Sokolov back before that weapon is complete,
wait, this is Jack?
We'll be facing a major crisis. The clock is ticking.
No, this... Wait, isn't this the 60s? So how
once
is this...
Once we've confirmed the rescue, Sokolov, stand by at the recovery point. A recovery balloon will be dropped at that point. Helium will be pumped into the balloon to inflate it. The process takes about 20 minutes.
I will not ask. I will watch. I will
once
play.
Once it's complete, the gunship's arm will latch onto the balloon and pull it up.
The Fulton surface-to-air recovery system. I'm familiar with the theory.
Take it
Wait
easy.
A minute.
It's been combat
the fuck is that voice?
Do you think Sokolov is up to it?
The shock will be less than during a parachute jump, and the arm can handle up to 500 pounds.
So you're planning on going over the border in a single combat talent?
David Hayter is voicing a guy named Jack.
He's equipped with 2 6-barrel 20mm Vulcan cannons, as well as 2 40mm machine guns.
My head hurts.
Sounds like you could hold her own against a battalion of tanks.
Even with the fuel in the reserve tank, we're facing a 4-hour time limit. If all goes well, it shouldn't take more than a few hours.
Home in time for dinner.
But also, please no spoilers, chat. Ever.
You'll be eating
never
dinner,
any spoilers, even if I question.
The rest of your meals in the jungle.
I want to do this for the first time. I am really confused, though. Oh, shit. Vital piece of equipment was snagged on a tree. The emergency rations and the KY jelly. Relief will not be found. Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater. It says that on the helmet. Oh, there goes the immersion. Jack being voiced by David Hayter, who looks a bit like Raiden, who yep
CQC.
Someone explain to me what the fuck is happening. It all becomes clear eventually. All right, don't explain. Just don't worry about it. Okay, I gotta kind of get used to the inventory a little bit anyway and figure out what the hell I'm doing. Fella named Jack. So this is the radio. Alright, so I got a knife. It's not a knife, this is a real knife. Ah! Oh, sweet God, that was amazing.
Do you copy? You're already in enemy territory, and somebody might be listening in. From here on out, we'll be using code names to refer to each other. Your code name for this mission will be Naked Snake. I'll be referring to you as Snake from now on. You're not to mention your real name.
Snake?
What, you don't like snakes?
What do you mean?
You've eaten one before, haven't you?
In survival training.
I'm glad to hear that.
I don't know if I'd ever order one in a restaurant, but...
Be careful. You might not have a choice.
What about you, Major? What should I call you?
Let's see. I'll be Tom. Call me Major Tom.
Wow.
Oh, and Snake.
Yeah.
I sang.
The crew isn't watching anymore. You can take
verse...
off the disguise now.
Good idea. This isn't right. Time for the snake to shed his skin.
I sang a verse of that song of Space Oddity when I first started streaming this for no reason. I just did. Okay, so that was a Kojima ruse. For people who were upset about Raiden, I guess, being the protagonist of Metal Gear Solid 2. And he was like, hey, you know what? Let's fuck around with the audience a bit, shall we? Ground control to Major. I hear there's a lot of Bowie references now that I think about it. I think subconsciously I knew.
This will be a sneaking mission. You must not be seen by the enemy. You must leave no trace of your presence. Is that clear? This kind of infiltration is the Fox unit's speciality. In other words, weapons and equipment are procured on site. That goes for food as well. You're completely naked, just as your name implies.
Great. Now I see why you asked me if I like snakes. I suppose calling me Snake was your idea of a joke, too.
No. There's a good reason for that. I'll tell you later when the time is right.
Gotcha. Getting back to the subject, how exactly am I supposed to feed myself?
You've been issued a knife and a tranquilizer gun. Use them to hunt for food. You'll also find some medical supplies in your backpack.
Yeah, about the backpack. I lost it in a tree on the way down.
I see. Well, you'd better go back and get it then. You know where it is?
No problem. I can see it from here. It's stuck on a branch.
To climb a tree, stand in front of a tree that's covered in ivy and press the action button. I'll be monitoring your progress over the radio. We can't risk violating Soviet airspace, but I'll be in the gunship. My frequency is 140.85. I'll give you a call if I need to talk to you. If you need to talk to me, use the send function. Okay, Snake, go get your backpack.
It's always weird to me when a game, like, press the action button against a tree. That's like, you know, you could have just had, like, maybe a tutorial, just do that, like, anyway. But, you know, that's fine. Now we know we gotta press the action button. Alright, so... So this is a Metal Gear game with free camera. With totally free reign. I gotta figure out how the fuck to get over there, because I really don't know what I'm doing. Oh, yeah. Well, I guess that makes sense. Yo, I just killed a snake and he turned into a box. What exactly is the action? Okay, it's Y, or the triangle, I guess, if you play on PlayStation. There we go. So again, this is my first time playing this, so kind of just figuring things out as I go along.
I see you've retrieved your backpack, Snake. To equip a weapon, it's necessary to take it out of your backpack. In the survival viewer, choose weapon from the backpack. Your available weapons will be displayed in a window in the upper left. From that list, choose the weapon you want to equip and press the enter button. For other equipped items, just do the same thing from item.
Got it. Use the survival viewer backpack.
Yep, that's right.
Got it.
Survival is fundamental to this mission. After you've been out in the field for a while,
if you're dead, you won't be able to complete the mission.
If your stamina gets too low, it'll affect your performance. You won't be able to shoot accurately, for example, and your wounds won't heal as smoothly. Keep an eye on your stamina so you don't run out. To recover lost stamina, you can hunt for local flora and fauna. You can use either your tranquilizer gun or your knife to hunt.
My only weapon is a Mark 22 Hush Puppy tranquilizer gun?
That's right. It's been fitted with its own suppressor. However, the suppressor will deteriorate every time
Sorry
you
about
fire.
The echo.
Once its durability Thought it was an effect zero, in the game. The noise suppression effect will be gone. So don't get too trigger happy with it. The suppressor's durability is shown in the icon. Any weapons and equipment beyond what you're carrying now, you'll have to find as you go.
I have to find my own weapons and equipment? Whose crazy idea was this anyway?
Solo covert action.
Kind of sounded better with the echo.
Operating procedure. You can't leave any traces of your presence. No weapons, equipment, footprints, sweat, or bodily waste. The same goes for bullets and cartridges, too. Your presence in enemy territory is already a violation of international conventions of warfare. There aren't supposed to be any American soldiers in Russia. It could spark an international incident. You can't let anyone see you. You can't let the enemy know you're there. This is a stealth mission. You're a ghost, Snake, in every sense of the word. And there'll be no rescue if you're captured. The military and U.S. government will deny any involvement in the affair.
Then I'll just have to take care of myself, huh?
I'm afraid so. You've been given a fake death pill for that purpose. SIS guidelines stipulate that soldiers on covert ops like this one be issued a potassium cyanide capsule. Tape it to your body so you can take it when you need to.
How generous of you.
Use it if you're taken prisoner by the enemy. It'll send you into a state of false death for a short time.
Fooling them into thinking that I'm really dead. So how do I come back to life?
Just take the revival pill.
You mean that thing they put in my tooth before the mission?
That's the one. But be careful. If you remain in a state of false death for too long, nothing will be able to bring you back. Remember that.
I'll keep it in mind.
Interesting.
You said this was a solo mission, right?
Right.
I guess that means I can't count on any reinforcements.
Correct. The mission rests entirely in your hands.
You die, except that you're able to tongue your tooth.
Relax.
That's the only thing you can do.
Support team ready to back you up over the radio.
Who?
I'll introduce them to you. This time, survival is of utmost importance. The first member of the support team will be in charge of monitoring your physical condition, acting as a medic, so to speak, as well as recording your mission data. She's a member of FOX as well, and she's here on the gunship with me.
She?
Hello, Snake. I'm paramedic. Nice to meet you.
Whoa.
As in a medic who comes in by parachute.
Oh.
Aren't you going to tell me your real name?
Are you going to tell me yours, Mr. Snake?
My name, huh? It's John Doe.
And they call you Jack for short. You're a regular Captain Nemo.
A name yes. means nothing on the battlefield. After a week, no one has a name. What's your name?
Jane Doe.
Paramedic.
Very funny.
That's my real name.
I wasn't joking, but I'll tell you my name only if you manage to make it back alive. My frequency is 145.73.
She's also in charge of recording your mission data. Whenever you want to save, send a message over the reserved save frequency, 140.96.
So saving lets me record my mission data.
That's right. It also records the state of your health.
Good to know.
There's one more person I want to introduce you to, Snake.
Huh?
Speaking of snakes, you remember the boss, don't you? A legendary soldier and your mentor. Actually, it was the boss that got the DCI's authorization in the first place. She's going to be serving as Fox's mission advisor.
The boss is?
She also helped me plan this mission. She and I were at SAS together.
Jack, is that you? How many years has it been?
Is that his real name? Boss? Jack?
That's right. It's me. Talk to me. Let me hear your voice.
Meryl?
It's been 5 years, 72 days, and 18 hours.
Jesus.
You've lost weight.
You can tell just by the sound of my voice.
Of course I can. I know all about you.
Really? Well, I don't know anything about you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Why'd you disappear on me all of a sudden?
I was on a top-secret mission. You didn't need me anymore.
But there were still so many things I wanted you to teach me.
No, I taught you everything you needed to know about fighting techniques. I taught you all I could.
CQC?
The rest you needed to learn on your own.
Techniques, sure. But what about how to think like a soldier?
How to think like a soldier? I can't teach you that. A soldier needs to be strong in spirit, body, and technique. And the only thing you can learn from someone else is technique. In fact, technique doesn't even matter. What's most important is spirit. Spirit and body are like two sides of a single coin. They're the same thing. I can't teach you how to think. You'll just have to figure it out for yourself. Listen to me, Jack. Just because soldiers are on the same side right now doesn't mean they always will be. Having personal feelings about your comrades is one of the worst sins you can commit. Politics determine who you face on the battlefield. And politics are a living thing. They change along with the times. Yesterday's good.
Yep, this is a Metal Gear game, all right.
Is that why you abandoned me?
No, it had nothing to do with you. I already told you, Jack, I was on a top secret mission. A soldier has to follow whatever orders he's given. It's not his place to question why. But you're looking for a reason to fight. You're a natural born fighter, but you're not quite a soldier. A soldier is a political tool, nothing more. That's doubly true if he's a career soldier. Right and wrong have no place in his mission. He has no enemies and no friends. Only the mission. You follow the orders you're given. That's what being a soldier is.
I do whatever I have to get the job done. I don't think about politics.
That's not the same thing. Sooner or later, your conscience is going to bother you. In the end, you have to choose whether you're going to live as a soldier or just another man with a gun.
A golden
gun.
There's
a saying in the Orient, loyalty to the end. Do you know what it means?
Being patriotic.
It means devoting yourself to your country.
I follow the president and the top brass. I'm ready to die for them if necessary.
The president and the top brass won't be there forever. Once their terms are up, others will take their place.
I follow the will of the leader. No matter who's in charge.
People aren't the ones who dictate the missions.
Then who does?
The times. People's values change over time, and so do the leaders of a country. So there's no such thing as an enemy in absolute terms. The enemies we fight are only enemies in relative terms, constantly changing with the times. As long as we have loyalty to the end, there's no point in believing in anything, even in those we love.
And that's the way a soldier's supposed to think.
The only thing we can believe in with absolute certainty
is ourselves.
Is the mission, Jack.
Oh,
all
mission.
Right. But do me a favor.
Or is it our spirit?
What is it?
Call me Snake.
Snake. Oh, right. Your code name is Snake. It suits you well.
What's
that's
that
right.
To
the
be?
Legendary unit that the boss put together during World War II was a snake. The Cobra unit. A group of heroes that brought the war to an end and saved the world. As long as you've got a legendary hero backing you up, you'll be fine. Isn't that right, Snake?
Yeah. I can't think of anyone else I'd rather have with me. Oh, and one more thing, boss.
Yes?
It's good to hear your voice again.
Same here. After all, who knows if either of us will make it out alive? Snake, you are always best at urban warfare and infiltrating buildings. But this is the jungle. Survival is going to be key. Those CQC techniques I taught you are sure to come in handy.
CQC? Close quarters combat, huh? I've been in the Green Berets for the past few years. I'm probably pretty rusty.
Not to worry. I'll be here to help you remember. After all, this is your first actual survival mission. I'll be supporting you over the radio.
Where are you, boss? Next to the Major?
The boss is communicating with us by radio from aboard a permit-class submarine in the Arctic Ocean.
Technology,
my
man.
My frequency is 141.80. Call me if you need my advice on battle techniques.
Gotcha.
Your mission is to retrieve Dr. Sokolov. Dr. Sokolov is being held in an abandoned factory located to the north of your current position. Avoid heavy combat and don't let anyone see you. Don't forget that this is a stealth mission.
Many will see me. I promise you that. Many will see me. It's been a very long time since I played a Metal Gear game.
Some of the basics of CQC.
What? CQC? Yeah. Oh.
Commencing virtuous mission now.
It's funny. Metal Gear is funny to me sometimes. It like has its own set of rules. No one will see me like this. Motion D. Consumes battery power. Snakes. What is this? The rabbit? What is this rabbit technique that Snake has adopted? It's amazing how I'm able to change the camera to reverse, but I can't actually change the aiming controls to be reversed. At all. Own view. Hang on. Wait. Maybe it's called own view, which is a really weird way to put it, but yeah, now it's good. We can kind of wiggle. Yeah, that's something I gotta figure out. Okay, just kind of, again, getting a feel for the controls. I heard something over there. Okay, all right, so this is going to be a lot of fun, isn't it? A lot of killing snakes and other creatures, and a lot of me not being able to fully stand up because you got to press the button twice. So you can't actually crawl around on the ground. Well, you can crawl, but you can't, like, crouch move. That was implemented for the 3DS version, where you could actually move around in this state. In this game, though, in this version, you can't do that, and I believe that was also... I'm not 100% sure, I believe it was like that in the PS2 version as well, the original. But yeah, there is the crouch walk ability in 3DS. Can't kill the butterflies. Damn. What?
Snake.
I had more health than that. I got kicked in the face by an alligator and I died? Oh, I sunk in quicksand. Oh. Strong, independent gator who don't need no man. The realism. Guys, the realism. Thank God. Oh, I got enough gator meat to last me at least a week. Guys, this game is wacky. There's some wacky shit happening here. Eat the bird? I don't know. So there's a lot of detail here in the map. A lot of landmarks. Got flage. Oh yeah, guys, I can. Is that legal? I could be Jack. Look at him. He's so handsome. I'm gonna go for woodland because you gain a little bit of a flage bonus apparently. No one will ever see me if I just wear that. Oh, fucking Rambo. Well, at the moment, I'm going to go for, I think, tree bark. Okay. Are we actually going to fight people this time? Or, uh-oh, there's people, guys.
Major, I've spotted two enemy soldiers.
They're probably KGB troops sent to guard Sokolov.
AK-47s and grenades.
Just a close-up of the mouth. Grenades.
Snake, your presence in Soviet territory is already a violation of international law. We can't let the Kremlin find out that the CIA and the American government are involved. Contact with the enemy is strictly prohibited. Don't engage them in battle either. This is a stealth mission. Got that?
The Major is right. The point of this mission is to sneak through the jungle without being seen.
What if they see
me? The success of the mission depends on how well you use your camouflage. Change your camouflage by selecting Camouflage from the Survival Viewer.
All right, well, I the uniform figured that one out already.
You pick your uniform, while the face option lets you change your face paint. Choosing camouflage that blends in with your surroundings will help you conceal yourself more effectively. Also, don't forget that anything that moves will stand out in the jungle. If you just stand up and run around like an idiot, you're bound to be spotted.
What do you mean? I'm not an idiot.
Crawl instead. You should be able to sneak by without being noticed.
Did you see me kill those alligators? Definitely not an idiot.
Looking at the camo index. The camo index shows how well your current camouflage blends in with the surrounding area. The higher the value, the harder you are to spot, and vice versa. The key is to make yourself one with nature. Keep that in mind as you go along, okay?
And his name is John Cena! Can I be him? That'll scare the enemies into no conflict. Taste unknown.
Tasty.
He likes snake. He is a snake eater. Fuck, this guy's coming this way, guys. What do I do? How did he break his neck? I got this though, guys. Look. I'm gonna stab him in the dick multiple times until he dies. This is a stealth mission. Do not engage the enemy in combat. Unless you want to stab them to death while smoking a cigar. Am I playing the game right yet? Is this how you play the game? I think he's dead, Jim. Drugunov sniper rifle. Wow. Start me out with the sniper rifle that quick. Well, this is interesting. So, this is just like a quick pose. For your own good. We gotta get you out of the potential line of sight. We don't need anyone seeing this. I mean, you know, what me and you were about to do. We don't need anyone seeing it. Actually, that patch of grass was just fine. So where exactly is this sniper rifle that I just got, supposedly? I see. I get it. So you have to put it in your inventory. I see now how this works. It's not like the other Metal Gear where you could just like fucking, you know, have everything at once. Is that a fucking bird? No, bird, come here. Shit, I was hungry. I wanted some fucking bird. How do you not shoot? Oh, you gotta press a button, I guess. It's no one, comrade.
Nobody here.
How do you use the scope? Oh, it's the Y button. Wait, no, that's not working. I just no-scoped! I just no-scoped the second enemy in the game. Oh God. What is this stealth? I'm playing the 360 version. How the fuck? What the fuck? One of the trigger buttons for first person. Oh, it's the left. Now it's left. That's weird. It was the right trigger before. Now it's the left trigger. All right. I guess that's well, this weapon clearly does not have a silencer, so I'm just going to try to avoid that one, you know, for future altercations. Also, I may need to do something here. Sorry. Again, I'm getting used to the game. I want to try that. Oh, wait, no, I want to try that. There it is. Gotta wiggle all the goodies out of you. Well, no one heard the gunshot. That snake sounds like footsteps. Whenever I hear a snake, I think it's a dude. Oh, there is actually a dude there. This will be my preferred method of execution from my playthrough of Metal Gear Solid 3. Tranking them and then stabbing them repeatedly in the head until they die. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Is that water over there, or is it just mud? Because I could drown him in, if it's water. Let's find out. It's just mud. Alright, well, it's killing time. I'm so sorry, but I can't let you live. God, this is barbaric. There's gotta be a better way to do this. Killed. There was another guy I killed, and I didn't get his stuff. Oh boy, time to go killing again. Carbopolis Michael only kills because he has to. Sleeping enemies drop two things. Oh, okay. I may need a ration. In a second. Oh, beautiful. Wasps? He's smiling. Look at Snake smiling like a son of a bitch. This guy is demented. He loves that. I gotta be honest, I was smiling just as much as he was, though.
Not the bees, not the bears.
Oh shit, they're all running away. God damn it. I thought the Xbox had pressure sensitive buttons. Why is that not working? Ointment and R nest. Oh, it's a good thing we got ointment. Just in case, you know, ball things happen. R fruit. Oh, cool. Yeah, I saw them fruits up in them trees. And I knew. I knew. Okay, that wasn't a fruit. Shit, Indiana Jones Bridge. It's rickety, it's crickety, it's wobbly. No ticket. I heard a guy, he moaned. There's a guy that's moaning. Oh, there's multiple men's. There are so many men's. Guys, what is this? What am I doing now? There's so many men. They're coming back. Assumedly to take care of the wasp problem. I was told that this is a stealth mission. Can't use my grenades. There's still one more men's. That might be the last of them. The rest of them might be over on the other side. Oh wait, there's a guy kind of around. How long do they sleep for? Like, do I even have to, like, knife this guy, or can I just let him use your radars, Vinny? Okay. Like that noise. Was someone coming or what? Oh yeah, it is someone. It's this guy. Let's see if he doesn't notice his sleeping friend. Naturally sleeping. He just fell asleep. Less than 15 feet away from him. Maybe like 20 feet, but still, oh shit. This might be a problem. That might be a problem. So let's just neutralize the problem, shall we? Wait, guys, what if... I may have an idea... Oh, shit. The guy, other guy's coming back. I was gonna throw him over the edge. But I don't know if that's gonna work. I mean, it could work. It's just, I'm worried about this other guy. Here, I might be able to, like, kind of throw him off here. My methods are barbaric. Where is this guy now? Okay. Go back across the bridge, man. Go back across the bridge. Very good. Compromising position. I don't want any of the other soldiers to see this. That would be weird. That would be real weird. Get real weird with it. Goodbye. Goodbye, brave soldier. There's things down here, guys. Secrets. XM-16E. So we got some new things here. We got some goodies. First, I'm going to eat this fucking reticulated python.
Ah, that's tasty.
Yeah. And then we'll unpack it. I got a fucking ration in here I probably need to get rid of. smoke grenade, huh? Wait, so how do I get the silencer on this thing? Several modifications. Press the A button to attach. Oh, I gotta press the A button. Where? Hang on. Let's do that again. RT info. Open the window and press the A button to detach. Attach a suppressor. Fucking hell. I need a suppressor, yeah. I don't have one. I mean, I could use the weapon, but it won't have a suppressor, so let's just not use that for now. Smoke grenade. Grenade. Stun grenade. No motion nearby. That could just mean someone's still. Maybe not. It might be good. Okay, there's another area. Oh, food can go bad, that's right. Okay, try to remember that. I'm gonna get one of my own rations.
Major, I've reached the abandoned factory where Sokolov is supposedly being held. This place is a dump.
Fiber brownies.
I can't see Sokolov from here. The security
can't see shit, Captain.
There are sentries posted around the perimeter. I wonder how many are inside.
I figure if I'm going to be buying brownies,
your objective, so
they may as well be good to eat factory. When you wake
be
up.
Holding him in a room in the northeast
so
section.
Northeast section.
They're not like completely be disgusting careful. For you.
Your mission
and I love me some brownies.
He must not be exposed to any kind of danger. Do not approach Sokolov while in the alert phase.
Right.
Oh, and one more thing, Snake.
You mean there's more?
No, it's just that when you get to Sokolov, I want
They're
you to
decent.
Tell him something from me.
And that is?
Sorry for being so late.
Is that all?
Yes.
Understood. Beginning my approach to the target.
No, it's just Fiber One. It's good poop brownies. That's what I call them. Good poop brownies. Just realized just how many people watching me hear me say good poop brownies live on stream. 2200. I've clearly become way too comfortable streaming. Gonna be struggling with that. I mean, this looks like it works here. Nothing. Saw me. I thought I was invincible. I guess they know there's a U.S. soldier here now. God damn it, stop coughing. Stop coughing, asshole.
HQ. This is HQ.
Patrol here. We've lost sight of the enemy. Commence alert formation.
Acknowledged. The enemy is still nearby. Pursue and engage him.
God damn it, and it was such a stupid way to get caught, too. I was busy fucking around in menus.
Nobody here.
Nobody here. I agree. Definitely not. Oh no, oh god. Oh god, what have I done? I've made a terrible mistake. Still need to fucking figure out the controls. Like, still fighting against the controls a good portion of the time, trying to figure out how to play the goddamn game. Oh great, that guy's gonna wake up in a second. We can't have that happen. Sleep. Just having a little nap. shotgun. Man, for a stealth game, they sure give you a lot of ways to fucking blow someone away. Fucking shotgun. I want to stealth my way to victory with the shotgun.
HQ.
This is HQ.
Patrol here.
Uh-oh.
Unable to locate the problem.
Understood. Return to your position.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Huh? Who is that?
No one. No one's here.
What's wrong?
Nothing!
What happened?
Ah! Nothing's wrong. Because you know what? Fuck this guy. Damn it, this fucking game. Nope, see, you walk against a wall and then you face the other way immediately. So it makes it a little hard to shoot. Also, Snake's arm looks broken when he's using this weapon. You wouldn't shoot me while your friend is here, would you? Good. Yeah, CQC, yeah. Yeah, CQC. Did I just kill everything here? Yeah, I think every enemy in like a 2 mile radius is now dead. Stealth. Stealth. Huh! What is it good for? Absolutely nothing. Who cares, my boy?
You must be Sokolov. Are you one of Vulcan's men? You'll never get it from me.
No. I'm a CIA agent. I've come to escort you back to the other side of the Iron Curtain.
You're CIA?
Yeah. I was sent by Major Zero, the man who got you out 2 years ago.
Zero?
I have a message from him.
What is it?
He said to tell you sorry for being so late.
Shoot him with a shotgun.
Did he?
Best one-liner.
What does it mean?
It means he's a man of his word.
Mustache.
But we've got no time for this. You have to get me out of here before they arrive.
Who's they?
Colonel Volgin of Gru. You in the West know him as Thunderbolt.
Thunderbolt? Never heard of him.
He's a member of the Army's extremist faction, a man who seeks to seize control of the motherland. Ever since the Cuban Missile Crisis 2 years ago, Khrushchev has been pursuing a policy of peaceful coexistence with the West. Despite resistance and criticism from hawks in the Army and the provincial authorities, Khrushchev has managed to suppress the opposition so far. But the failure of his agricultural policies has put him in a precarious position. And on top of that, the tragedy last November.
President Kennedy's assassination.
Precisely. In a sense, Khrushchev has lost his biggest partner, and his power base is rapidly crumbling away. A certain group is plotting to use this opportunity to seize power by rallying the anti-government forces, overthrowing Khrushchev, and installing Brezhnev and Kosygin in his place. The mastermind behind this plot is Colonel Volgin of the Gru. He has control over another secret weapons research facility much like this one, OKB-812, known as the Gronin Design Bureau, and is using it to further his plans. But that is not enough to satisfy him. Now he's plotting to seize the secret weapon I have been developing here and use it as leverage in his bid for power.
You bastard. Is that what satisfies him? Secret weapons?
The intelligence says that they are going to make their move during the test.
Then, the soldiers outside.
Exactly. They wouldn't need that many men just to keep me inside.
Darren
Leaf.
Their orders
were to prevent Colonel Volgin from capturing me. Even if it meant killing me in the process, or so it would seem.
Ear clip monocle.
Volgin will come. I'm sure of it. You must get me out of here before then.
Leave it to me.
Leave it to Beaver. That was a joke. American television.
By the way, your Russian is superb. Where did you learn to speak it?
From my mentor.
Is that so? America is truly a frightening country.
Having second thoughts?
No. I have no love for this place. Let's go.
Are we embarking on an escort mission? Is it timed? And is it underwater? Because if the answer is to yes, answers to these questions are
Major,
yes.
This is Snake.
Then I'll be
so
very happy.
Is safe with me. He's doing fine. No injuries.
Good work, Snake. Now hurry up and get Sokolov to the recovery point. We'll rendezvous with you there.
Roger.
What about the sentries?
I had to kill them. There was no other way. But no one will know we were involved.
I see.
What about the boss?
We lost contact with the boss some time ago.
What happened?
It's probably just a weak signal. Just hurry and get Sokolov out of there.
Let's do this. I killed everyone. Like, everyone's dead with a shotgun and or an M16. So, we got this, Sokolov. You're gonna be okay, buddy. We're gonna bring you back to freedom. What is this? Is like kung fu? What the fuck is he doing? He's trying to create a cyborg. Oh, I saw something. I think I just saw Valdo.
Freeze!
Okay, I thought everyone here was dead. Where did you guys come from?
So this is the legendary boss. Huh? Huh? We meet at last.
You! You're from the Ocelot unit of Spetsnaz.
Huh?
What's a Gru soldier doing here?
He's got a PP.
Soldier?
PP9? PPK? I guess he didn't start with the revolvers, huh?
He's the Ocelot commander.
That's Major Ocelot to you. And don't you forget it.
What is the... So animated. Slightly flamboyant.
Sokolov is ours. Now get out of here.
And Ocelot never lets his prey escape.
What?
Yo, did you see that guy's mouth moving? Yo, Sokolov's mouth was going real fast for a second. Smooth jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1. Whoa! My mic crackled just as he fell. Oh, thanks. Thanks for helping me out, Ocelot. Appreciate it.
I can't say it feels good to kill a comrade, even if it is for the Gru.
Sokolov, take cover.
Huh. You're not the boss, are you?
You fucking what?
Gru operatives?
Why couldn't we just use the other soldiers? Why do we have to let them die?
What's that stance? That gun.
Wow!
If you're not the boss, then die.
Major! Leave it! Shoot the other one! Whoa!
Yeah, get some Matrix shit going on here. Shoot him in the heart and you'll kill two in a row. No? Alright, never mind. Snake's going for a kill streak.
ejected the first bullet by hand, didn't you? I see what you were trying to do, but testing a technique you've only heard about in the middle of battle wasn't very smart. You were asking to have your gun jam on you. Besides, I don't think you're cut out for an automatic in the first place. You tend to twist your elbow to absorb the recoil. That's more of a revolver technique.
Oh, shit.
You filthy American dog!
Got your beat, buddy.
But that was some fancy shooting. You're pretty good.
Pretty good.
I'm confused, but I enjoyed the interaction. Colonel, I mean, Major Tom.
Major,
everyone's fucking dead.
I read you.
Yet again.
Snake, you all right?
I've run into a few snags. These guys were after Sokolov, too. Apparently, they were taking orders from a GRU colonel named Volgan.
A GRU colonel?
Part of an internal Soviet power struggle, according to Sokolov. Something between the KGB and GRU. Between Khrushchev's supporters and Volgan's.
Sokolov was being guarded by the KGB and hunted by GRU? Snake, it sounds like this could be even hotter than Cuba.
I don't like it. Something about the whole thing stinks.
I agree. You'd better hurry.
Sokolov ran off by himself, but I'll catch up to him.
We're counting on you.
Mousetrap? What? Look what I've done to him! His legs are all up and shit. When he wakes up, he's gonna be like, what the fuck happened to me? All of them, all of their legs should be up firmly. We're telling me to kill Ocelot. Alright. Who cares if he's dead? Let him stay dead. Fuck him. He means nothing to me. The boy means nothing to me. It literally is just a mousetrap. Oh, I've got a magazine. Is that an actual magazine or is it like a weapon magazine? I wonder. Okay, yeah, it's not what I thought it was. Go back, kill Ocelot, and wait. Ugh. All right, if that's what you want. Oh, look, it's a mouse. If only I had a mouse trap. Oh, what the fuck am I doing down here? Oh, this probably would have come in handy earlier if I had utilized this properly. Fucking shoot snakes with M16s. That's the kind of player I am. That's how I play the game. Rat. Oh, I'm gonna eat that. As soon as it goes bad, I'm gonna eat it. Is this what you want?
Time paradox.
What was that? It was that Colonel Campbell. The future will be changed. You'll create a time paradox. Asimat Garded Parad Para Osimo Paradiddle. Simo parade. Gay pride parade. Oh, time paradox. Okay. So it's like Colonel Campbell is telling the story, or like he and Snake are recounting the story or something. Whatever. Doesn't matter. Alright, the flash. We gotta get the flash. Camo flash. Tiger stripe. Also, I think this is the only way to go. Maybe, yeah, it just looks like I gotta go back this way. Again, this is my very first time playing this game, so I still kind of have no idea what I'm doing. But I'm enjoying the game a lot, and I could see myself getting really into this.
Okay. Those men were from the Ocelot unit.
Spetsnaz?
Yes. The best crew has to offer. They're coming for me. I'm finished!
Calm down. I'll get you out of here, I promise. And we've got some of the best backup we could ask for.
Look.
Uh-oh. We had good backup, but I think they were just shot by a cannon.
That's what they were making you build.
Yes. The Shagohod. The treading behemoth. A tank capable of launching nuclear IRBMs.
It can launch nuclear missiles from that kind of terrain?
Oh, yes. And without support from friendly units.
A nuclear-equipped tank capable of operating solo.
It looks like it's made of metal.
Is that thing finished?
No. This is only the end of Phase 1. It won't be truly finished until we complete Phase 2.
Never quite got the mouth movements localized, did they?
If it is completed and the Colonel gets his hands on it, it will mean the end of the Cold War.
The end of the Cold War?
Yes. And then the Age of Fear will truly begin.
A world war.
I had no choice but to cooperate.
I didn't want to die. I wanted to see my wife and child again in America. Please, take me to America, quickly. They cannot complete it without my help.
Got it. Let's go.
Someone's gonna shoot him in the head, aren't they? That's never that simple. Someone's gonna get shot in the head, and it's gonna be him.
Paramedic, I've discovered a giant crab. Ugh. It's got claws like a tank.
It's like someone just stuck their finger in his belly button and rubbed around. And he was just like, oh.
Boss. Boss, is that you? There's a twist this early in the game?
Good work, Jack.
What are you doing here?
Sokolov comes with me.
Apparently, Boss has control over the elements and nature.
Hornets.
Oh no, that guy does though. It's like you forget that there's this weird kind of supernatural-ish element in the Metal Gear games. Or at the very least, highly advanced and weird technology. You just forget about it. Until it just out of nowhere, that happens.
My friends, let us fight together again.
I have waited long for this day.
What is this voice?
We will fight with you once more.
Yes.
Welcome back, Boss.
Now that all five of us are together, it's time we go to the depths of hell itself. It's raining blood. Is he crying?
So confused.
Kuwabara, Kuwabara.
I guess Volgan? Is that you?
Ah, what a joyful scene.
Like the word Volt?
Colonel Volgan.
Yeah.
Welcome to my country. And to my unit.
Boss, what is this?
I'm defecting to the Soviet Union. Sokolov is a little gift for my new hosts.
Recoilless nuclear warheads. These will make a fine gift for me.
This can't be happening.
Who is he? Another one of your disciples? Are we taking him with us?
No, this one is still just a child. Too pure for us Cobras. He has not yet found an emotion to carry into battle.
What are you talking about?
Think you can pull the trigger?
Oh, right. It's not a gun anymore. Oh.
That looks like it sucks.
You've seen my face. We can't let him live.
Just change your face. Come on, you can control electricity. Just, like, zap your face into a different one.
If Khrushchev finds out about this, we're finished.
Let me guess, he can charge the bullets to eject.
Wait. He's my apprentice. I'll take care of him.
To eject them. He doesn't even need a gun.
You can't come with us.
He can just knuckle the bullets. That's right, guys. Knuckles is in this game.
Here.
Now, onto Sokolov's research facility.
Shagohod is ours.
The camp is part of the charm, isn't it?
Drift away. My place is with them now.
So long since I played a Metal Gear game for the first time. Fucking God, when did Metal Gear Solid 2 come out? Whenever that was. How old was I? Probably like 16. Yeah, I was 16. So playing this at 30, it's a little weird for me because, yeah, the camp factor is somewhat unexpected after that first kind of opening segment.
Snake, can you hear me?
Yeah, just barely.
Snake, listen to me. You need emergency medical treatment. Can you move? You've got to get those wounds treated. Hang in there. All right, let's get you fixed up. Paramedic?
Okay, Snake. Just relax and it'll all be over before you know it.
Wrap your arm up in a snake.
Stay with me. I've seen people in worse shape before. Think you can handle it?
Major. The boss. She's defected.
We'll talk about that later. First, we've got to get you patched up.
Okay, here we go. First, open the survival viewer with the start button. If you select cure, you can start the treatment. Healing is divided into treatment using medicine with the item window button and surgical treatment using the weapon window button. Your injuries include a fractured left elbow and rib bone, and lacerations on your upper arms, right elbow, and abdomen.
God, this is a lot more than I was expecting.
They need to be fixed using surgical treatment. Move the healing cursor with the left stick to the affected part of your body. Once you've selected the affected area, hold the weapon window button and use the left stick to select the medical item and then press the enter button. With this method, you can use items to help your recovery process. To treat a bone fracture, first secure the affected area with a fastener and then wrap it in bandages. That should do it. For lacerations, you'll need disinfectant to clean the wound, sutures to stitch it up, styptic to slow the flow of blood, and bandages to wrap the wound. If you do everything I mentioned, the wound should heal completely. Understood?
Yeah.
Stay with me. Go into the survival viewer and treat those wounds.
Okay. Can I just, like, press the ration button? What, you mean I can't use a cigar on my abdomen? Okay, we disinfected the wound. Bleeding. Broken bones. Suffering from a deep cut. Okay. Bone fractured over here. Use the knife, okay. Bandage. Bleeding. Okay, so disinfect. Six. That's not a broken bone. Whoops. Bandage. And suture. Bone fractured. Bandage. And bone is fractured, so I would imagine splint, deep cut. Hey, I'm alive. Oh, that was a nice noise. Is this how Snake got the legendary bandana? Except this isn't the Snake from the other games. This is Big Boss. Oh wait, no, he's using it as a...
Good job, Snake.
...cast.
We're coming to get you now. Just stay where you are. We'll drop a recovery balloon. Can you set it up?
Those don't look like recovery balloons. Looks like early Metal Gear. God damn it, boss. How could you betray me? If they saw each other, they have amazing eyesight. They've got some kind of ocular implants or something. He's about to explode in his pantaloons.
Excellent.
Over these items.
A great success. Thanks to the boss and her cobras, I have both Sokolov and the Shagohod.
What are we going to do with the girl?
Who is she?
Apparently she's Sokolov's woman.
She's a nice catch. I'll take her. Not so fast, my dear.
KGB.
We may be able to use her. She has spunk.
Shall we take her back to the base?
Perhaps we should. We have no further use for Sokolov's research facility. I think it's
what
time
is this comical rocket launcher? This looks like something out of fucking Fallout 3.
Colonel, even if they are our enemies, they're still our countrymen.
But it won't be me that pulled the trigger.
Is that a red rocket, guys?
It'll be our friend, the American defector.
You're going to nuke your fellow Russians?
Remember the Alamo.
Colonel!
Don't do it. You're gonna nuke your fellow Russians? Like he said? I think you helicopters are a little close to that nuclear explosion. Yep, Snake is trying to recover. Suddenly a nuke goes off. That's definitely not gonna help. The balloon is probably now fucking destroyed. This is not Snake's day, man. Everything's going wrong for Snake. It's all right, Stan. I'm just gonna get a little nuke. Thank you. You mean the game just now started? What a thrill. Oh yeah, I know some of the song. Oh, I'm gonna have to watch a James Bond movie later on, aren't I? What a thrill. I'm searching and I'll melt into you. You only live twice. But you're so supreme. Golden Eye. That guitar with the wah. There'll be no one else. Oh, it's such a perfect pastiche of the Bond movie themes. Look, the countries turn into the camouflage. Or the continents. This is wonderful. Unabashedly Bond. Feed on a tree frog. Gonna have to watch some James Bond soon. Real soon. But, you know, only the best Bond. George Lazenby. Only him. just his movies. I mean, movie.
Currently flying over the Arctic Ocean. Altitude 30,000 feet. Approaching Soviet airspace. Arriving at the designated drone launch point. Drone oil pressure and voltage are nominal. Payload oxygen supply is nominal. Power supply to payload antifreeze system shows no problems. No gusts. All systems go for drone detachment.
Snake, we can't risk a halo jump this time around. Airspace security has gotten tighter since we were last here. We can't get as close to the ground as we did during the Virtuous mission.
So they did recover,
so instead,
Snake.
Instead, we'll be using one of our newest weapons. Snake, you're being given an honor on par with Alan Shepard. This is our last chance. Show your patriotism. If you fail, you'll be back in a hospital bed again, waiting for the firing squad. So how does it feel to be a patient in one of the most advanced ICUs in the world?
Would you do me a favor and tell the suits about visiting hours? I'll never get better with them assaulting me day and night with their questions.
Must be part of the top brass's inquiry.
More like an interrogation. According to them, I'm a traitor and an accomplice to the boss's defection.
They're just looking for a scapegoat.
Does that mean they're after you too?
Let's just say neither one of us is going to be made a national hero out of this.
Does this mean Fox is going to die?
No. This Fox is still one step ahead of the hounds. The reason I came to see you today...
It'll be turning into Fox Jack, News in a few years.
It's time for Fox to clear its name.
What are you talking about?
The situation has changed. We still got a chance to come out of this one alive.
Yeah, what kind of chance?
Don't get too excited. Here,
Have a cigar. It's Cuban. This morning, I had a meeting with the CIA.
They decided when they're going to execute us?
No. Something even bigger. Yesterday, the White House received an unexpected call.
President Johnson?
Yes, I hear you, Mr. Chairman.
It was a hotline call from Khrushchev to President Johnson.
From the head of the Soviet Union?
That's right.
A few days ago, one of our country's main design bureaus, OKB-754, was destroyed in a nuclear explosion. At about the same time, our anti-aircraft radar picked up a signature that appeared to come from one of your military aircraft. Does any of this sound familiar to you? In retaliation, I have placed our armed forces on secondary alert. Depending on your response, I may be left with no choice but to order the military to maximum alert and unleash Armageddon. With the help of your predecessor, I was able to survive the Cuban incident. But my power is not as great as it once was. If I am to survive this crisis, I must have your full cooperation.
I should have contacted you myself. Did you know that one of our soldiers defected to your country a week ago?
No.
So you haven't heard that? The man who arranged the defection was a GRU colonel by the name of Yevgeny Borisovich Volgin.
Volgin? Of the Brezhnev faction. Go on. Who is the soldier?
Her name is the Boss. She's a living legend. During World War II, she was the one who led us to victory in that war. In Russia, you know her as Voyevoda.
You mean the Boss? The mother of your special forces?
Yes, that's the one. And she took two miniature nuclear shells along with her.
The Boss took two miniature nuclear shells?
I'm afraid so. I believe they were a gift for her new hosts. The Davy Crockett Atomic Battle Group delivery system was completed 2 years ago. But serious problems were found with the launcher's range and precision. Although they were mass-produced, they've never been deployed in battle.
But Sokolov's research facility was completely wiped out. The whole area is polluted.
I can only offer you my deepest condolences over this terrible tragedy.
So, the Boss, with Colonel Volgin's help, stole two experimental nuclear shells and took them with her as gift when she defected. Then, shortly thereafter, Sokolov's design lab, a top-secret military research facility, was destroyed by one of these weapons.
Like, we know this stuff because it's happened.
Yes, that's correct.
But I guess a recap is cool.
The American government denies any involvement in the affair. Is that right as well?
That's correct. We were not involved in any way.
Then what was a U.S. military aircraft doing on our radar screen? It was clearly in violation of our airspace. And yet you say it was not acting under your orders.
That's correct.
You expect me to believe that this was all the work of a single soldier?
I don't know what else to tell you.
The army insists that this is all a ploy on your part.
I've said it once, and I'll say it again, our government had nothing to do with it.
And I would like dearly to believe you. However, I'm afraid my power over the military has weakened since the Cuban incident. I will need some kind of proof that this was not the action of the American government. You have 1 week. You must catch the Boss yourselves and recover the remaining nuclear device. Then, you must find some way to prove your innocence.
Prove our innocence?
Yes, preferably something painful. Prove to me that this is not merely another one of your tricks.
Wesley Americans.
Boss should be close to Colonel Volgin. How about a little co-action?
I would not expect too much if I were you. The political situation here is unstable. And Colonel Volgin is a member of the Brezhnev faction, which seeks to topple my government. 1 week. You have only 1 week. And if it is not too much to ask, do something about Volgin as well.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It means nothing. Call it a modest gentleman's agreement to ensure our continued relationship.
What if we can't prove our innocence?
Then I will be unable to restrain the military. I will be ousted, and they will seek their revenge.
A nuclear attack on the United States?
I leave the disposal of this situation entirely to your discretion, Mr. President.
Disposal?
If you fail, it will mean the beginning of a new world war.
To put it simply, in order to avoid a full-scale nuclear conflict, we have to prove that America was not involved in that explosion.
And eliminating the boss ourselves will prove America's innocence?
Right. The higher-ups have decided that you're the only one capable of pulling this off. You were her last apprentice. Screw this one up, and we'll both be 6 feet under. There's no choice.
Hey, you guys want to learn about President Johnson? You should go to Google and type President Johnson.
Are the Russians going to be helping us?
Gets pants.
The KGB has promised to lend us one of their communications satellites so that you and I can talk to each other.
He talks about his tremendous
also
balls.
Put us in touch with a couple of insiders.
Insiders?
There was a defection in September 1960. Do you remember it?
You mean the two NSA codebreakers who went over to the Soviet Union?
Precisely. Since then, they've apparently been training with the KGB for exactly this kind of situation. Their code names are Adam and Eva. I've been told that Adam has infiltrated Volgin's ranks. We've also arranged for him to provide you with an escape route. You'll need to rendezvous with him when you get there.
I love 60s, like, jet technology. It looks so fucking awesome.
Control, unidentified aircraft detected, altitude 30,000 feet. Estimated airspeed exceeding Mach 3. Bearing south. I'm about to lose it.
But yeah, there's a video of President Johnson trying to get fitted pants. He's talking about how his pants don't fit properly because his nads are too big. And he uses the word nads. And he burps them. It's disgusting. That is his legacy. Yeah, that definitely seemed more discreet than a Halo jump. Safer, too.
This is Snake. Do you read me?
Loud and clear. Glad to see you landed safely.
I got blown pretty far off target.
Snake, let's go over your mission objectives one more time. Rescue Sokolov. Find out what's happened to the Shagahod. Then destroy it. And finally, eliminate the boss.
Eliminate the boss.
This mission will be codenamed Operation Snake Eater.
Because I'll be taking on the boss and our Cobra unit, right?
Don't forget about Colonel Volgin.
I'm not a hired killer.
I know, but that was the Kremlin's demand.
Demand? You mean it wasn't just a request? What's it to us if the Khrushchev regime is threatened by the Colonel and his faction?
If supporting the current regime helps us avoid a nuclear exchange, then that's what we'll do.
And what are the CIA's demands?
Our priorities are the rescue of Sokolov and the destruction of the Shagahod.
Roger that, Major Tom.
Hold on, Snake.
What now?
I'm changing my code name. It turns out Tom wasn't the most auspicious choice.
What do you mean?
Well, the truth is, when I chose my code name, I picked the wrong one.
The wrong one?
Did you ever see the movie The Great Escape? It came out last year.
I must have missed that one.
Anyway, it's based on a true story about prisoners who escaped from a POW camp in Nazi Germany. The prisoners dig three tunnels as part of their plan, but the Nazis find two of the tunnels before they're finished. The prisoners succeed in escaping by using the last remaining tunnel. The names of those three tunnels were Dick, Harry, and Tom.
I get it. You used the name of the tunnel they escaped in as your code name because you thought it would bring you good luck.
Yes, that's exactly right. At least, that was the plan.
But?
But I got the name wrong. The one they escaped in was Harry. Tom was one of the unlucky tunnels. It was discovered by the Nazis before it was finished. I watched the movie again just to make sure. In fact, I even ordered the actual film from the movie company.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like the greatest name to use. So what should I call you?
You know, let's just use Zero, like we've been doing all along.
All right, then. Major Zero it is. We'll start over from square one.
Yeah, this guy's a Major
from
Zero.
Square Zero. My frequency is 140.85. Oh, I almost forgot. Paramedic is with us again.
Hi, Paramedic.
Is this her last chance, too?
If we fail, she'll have her medical license revoked. It's more or less the same kind of fate. Her frequency is the same as during the Virtuous mission, 145.73. She'll be recording your mission data as well, just like the last time. That frequency is also the same, 140.96. And there's one more person on your support team. His name is Mr. Sigint. He's an expert on the latest in weapons and equipment technology. You'll be going up against some of the world's most advanced weaponry when you infiltrate the research facility. If you have any questions, just ask him. His frequency is 148.41.
Mr. Sigint, got it.
Adam, your KGB contact, is waiting for you at the abandoned factory up ahead.
The same factory Sokolov was being held in last week.
Yes, meet up with Adam first. He's cleared the way for you to rescue Sokolov.
How will I know this Adam guy when I see him?
You'll know once you reach the factory.
It's the only guy that won't try to kill you, Snake.
By the fallout from that nuclear blast. No one else would dare come close. The password is, who are the Patriots? And Lali Lulelo.
Lali Lulelo.
You've been equipped with a 45 for this mission.
No questioning that.
It's noisy.
I thought standard Fox procedure was procure on-site weapons acquisition.
The circumstances are different this time. You're now on an official mission for the United States government. It would be necessary to make your presence known to a certain extent, to the Khrushchev regime at the very least. But remember, this is still a sneaking mission. Snake, if you fail this mission, it will mean an all-out nuclear war. Keep that in mind and proceed with extreme caution.
Right.
Understood.
Lulelo.
Commencing Operation Snake Eater.
Wait, Major Zero. You want me to lay low? Is that what you're trying to say?
Paramedic.
Snake, it's so good to hear from you again.
What's up?
I'm here. It's been a week, hasn't it?
4 days, actually.
Huh?
I visited you in the hospital. You were still unconscious, though.
Then you must have seen me naked.
Yeah, but you were all wrapped up in bandages and tubes, so I couldn't do anything but look.
Better luck next time.
Let's hope so. But seriously, don't forget that you were like that until just yesterday. In fact, you really shouldn't even be on this mission. Keep an eye on your stamina gauge. If you start to run low, don't push yourself. Eat something to replenish your stamina. And try not to get yourself hurt. If you're wounded or get bitten by a venomous animal, go into the survival viewer immediately and treat yourself using Cure.
Yeah, yeah. I can see you still know how to nag.
You're welcome. And I can see you still don't know when to keep your mouth shut.
Maybe so. By the way, I heard you're going to lose your medical license if this mission fails.
Yes, there was talk of that, but the mission won't fail, will it?
Of course not.
Good. I believe in you. But you know what? I really don't care about my medical license.
Didn't they use that to force you to participate in this operation?
No, I volunteered.
Why?
So that I could watch over you.
Oh.
Snake,
sweet.
You're the best agent I've ever seen. But you push yourself too hard. You're reckless. Someone has to stop you from getting into trouble to make sure you and the boss don't kill each other. So that's why I volunteered. I mean, you couldn't ask for a better guardian angel than me, right?
Thanks.
Stop right there. You can thank me when you get back.
All right.
Love interest. All right, may as well meet this other fella, and then I'm going to save because it's almost 3 a.m. Jesus.
Yo, you're Snake, aren't you?
And you're Sigint?
None other.
I heard that you're an expert on weapons, equipment, and cutting-edge technology.
Close.
Huh?
I am the expert on weapons, equipment, and cutting-edge technology. I'm the guy that designed your trank gun, active sonar, and motion detector. If you want to know anything about weapons or equipment you find in the field, just send me a message and ask. Later.
Well, I guess he's just full of surprises.
Saving the game, Snake?
I like my team. I enjoy this team of people.
Hey, Snake, you ever heard of Godzilla, King of Monsters?
No. What is it?
It's a movie. You haven't seen it?
Nope.
It's about this monster called
Godzilla,
who grows to an enormous size in a nuclear test and goes on a rampage in Tokyo.
Nuclear test, huh? Then the Marshall Islands must be crawling with giant monsters right about now.
It's just make-believe.
Maybe that's why my pants have been so tight lately.
Snake, it's a movie.
It's because
of
the snake.
Out of Los Alamos.
I know. So then what happened?
Godzilla is immune to all weapons, and humanity has no way to stop the monster. Dr. Serizawa develops a new type of weapon, but meanwhile, Godzilla is getting closer and closer to Tokyo, obliterating everything in its path. It was originally a Japanese movie, but they made an American version, too. I recommend seeing the original Japanese one if you ever get the chance. It's mostly mindless fun, but it's also got a serious anti-nuke message as well.
Where can I see the original?
You'll just have to go to Japan.
Really? That's too bad.
Check out a DVD, Snake.
If you wait 40 years, you might be able to see it in America, too.
Why is that?
2004 will be Godzilla's 50th birthday.
You think they're still going to be making Godzilla movies then?
Of course. Everybody loves Godzilla.
You sure know a lot about movies.
I don't suppose you're the movie-watching type.
When did this game come out?
Not really.
Okay, then I'll tell you everything I know. When the going gets tough, movies can save your life. It's always good to be able to look at things from a different perspective when you get in a jam. That's the magic of movies.
No kidding. Well, I guess it might at least make a nice distraction.
That's the spirit, Snake.
2004, huh? No fucks given about the fourth wall. I hear snakes. I did it. I killed the snake. No one will know I'm coming. This is a stealth mission. This is a stealth mission. Must be stealthy. Stealth. Oh. Boop. Okay. No, that's enough. I really have been, I've been doing a lot, and it is 3 a.m., so will I be doing a no-kill mission or run? No, I won't be. This is my first time playing the game, so I'm just going to play the game. Not going to be doing any specialty runs or anything like that. I wouldn't even know where to begin doing something like that, so yeah. Just going to play the game. But it is 3 a.m. here in New York, and so far I'm really enjoying the 25 minutes of gameplay that I did play. But it was, you know, I mean, that's the thing. Metal Gear is kind of an interactive movie at times, and I'm okay with that. You just got to know what you're expecting. Yeah. And I think it's going to end up being a good stream. I'm going to enjoy this. But for now, we need to take a look at some of the art. Let's see. From Metamodi. Is it BRB? From Kaiser Pajeo. From the same person, grenades. Close up of the mouth. From Butt Burrito. Here's the Final Fantasy VII ending. The life stream is the mushroom. That's awesome. From MZ Fantic. From Kaiser Pajeo. I just want to say quality over quantity. What I mean by that is I prefer less pieces from the same artist per night to a few really, really well thought out ones. And I don't mind your art, Kaiser. I think you have potential, but you don't even finish drawing the person on the right. So, you know, just saying there, we do have some things on the Buru. I know people are going to hate me saying this, but seriously, just hear me out. There's a whole sticky readme about how we would prefer less from one artist and more quality from one artist. Like, you can spend more time on one piece than try to upload as many as you can as quickly as you can. All right. So just for everyone, there it is. From Pi Riot, grenades. Oh, God, that moment. See, from Kaiser Pajeo, good poop brownies. You know, I think you're kind of, you can do less. Like I said, from Waydesu, here's a really, really interesting and nice piece of Vine Sauce art. There's me amidst the shrooms. Very cool. This is from Metamodi again, but this time it's not a BRB. This is from my Final Fantasy VII stream. This is me in Popeye arm form from Beidou. From Majestic. I think I showed that yesterday. Yes, I did, actually. From Lord Convict. Vine Sauce. From Scrumblebunt. Scrumplebunt, sorry. I don't give a fuck. I'm fucking Bubsy, bitch. Now go get me some carpet to munch on. Jeez, Bubs, you know, you're pretty mean to me, but that takes the cake. Oh, I read it backwards. I don't know why I didn't figure that out. Gazorp, Azorp, fucking field. Okay, tonight I am actually going to check out a bit more of the art from the charity stream. So some of the art that I missed. And I missed a lot of it. So I'm going to be going through some of that. Let's see. I think I'm close. Okay. All right, so this one is, again, this is not from today's stream. This is from the charity stream. From Hamster Boy Genius. From Polo Robot. That's cool. I'm actually working on the Zelda Chaos Edition video, the highlight video, and it's actually coming out really good. It's been, like I said, I've been sick. A lot of shit's been going on. I haven't really had a chance to edit. I haven't really even had the motivation to edit, but now I'm feeling it. Like, I started doing the Chaos Edition video, and the first, like 4 full minutes of edit, you know, the first 4 full edited minutes are hysterical. And that's just the first 4 minutes. Like, the rest of the video, I think, is going to be equally funny because there were so many stupid moments. And then I didn't even get to the mailbox island yet. So, yeah, it's exciting. I think it's going to be a really fun highlight video. I'm excited to finish it. So expect that sometime either this weekend or just after the weekend. From Cold Carrera 121, there's Lint. from Stinkbug, I think I showed this, but this is the Banjo-Kazooie Corruptions. Very accurate. From Ketchum 1009, again, from the Chaos Edition, Wind Waker. From Luigi Bro Z, you found the LSD. From Molding Towel, every millisecond I live in agony. From Thunderwing, DDD ate him. From Benjo Games 2, the legend of what? Zindi? Have you ever heard of it? It's too mainstream for me. Oh, okay. From Onien, there's more Chaos Edition art from that one particular moment where it just looked amazing. Also from the charity stream, if you missed it, this one is not from any of my streaming, but it is by Seijo Kaijin. From Onien, there's Link Cat again. From Seijo Kaijin again, this is Chaos Edition art. From Fopples, hey. From Lich Pit, more Wind Waker art. It's really good. From Pyrochasm, like, there is one moment that if you didn't see it, it was awesome. It's just the filter got really weird and the game looked really bizarre, and it just looked so amazing though. The fucking Link was perfectly silhouetted against a cel-shaded background. It just looked so good. From ComJ, it explains the cat eyes. From Cold Carrera 121, I just edited that today, actually, just that particular person with the pot on her head. It was, I laughed so hard when I saw it again. From Beautiful Duwang, Link climbing from ropes and meowing. From Dr. Tapeworm, another of Link with the fire in his eyes. From Eroden, another of the same scene. I actually specifically asked for art of it, so. From that Grogan guy, Zelda Epilepsy Waker. From Eroden. From Sheepsy, Miss Hands. I believe that is what I called her. From King Giantess. Oh boy, look at this. I can feel my childhood disintegrating. Wow, look at that face. Look at both of their faces. Look at his body. Jesus, this is amazing. From Vriska, here's, I think, Felt Vineshroom, custom made. From Vriska, here's Bubsy art. What could possibly go wrong? You should have spelled it P-A-W-S-I-B-L-Y, possibly, go wrong. That way it could have been even more horrible to fit in with the horrible Bubsy puns. From Vriska, Power Stance. from Vriska. Here's some Kermit art from the charity stream. Always got to have a Kermit. I don't know if you guys saw, but the Muppets are coming back in a more adult version of their show. And they released like a clip or like a 10-minute kind of a promo video, and it was pretty good. I actually really liked it. So I might actually watch the Muppets when they come back. From Dijani 10. Record beaten. Again, all charity stream stuff. So if you don't really get it, it's a long story. This one's from Cybidizer. Let me see. Like I said, there's a lot of art for like other streamers that I won't fully understand. I'm not going to be even attempting to look at that because it would just be too much. There's just too much damn art. So I'm just trying to find stuff specifically related to my streams during the charity stream. From Xenon.
Yeah, Xenon. Do a barrel roll.
Derpy Vine Shroom. Vine Sauce. Pretty cool. It's 3D. From Technijou. Bubsy had a purpose in this world. Yeah, Bubsy helped raise money for charity. From the Mickey Rog. Oh, you know, Bubsy things just drowning. From Loser 357-2003. BRB. Load up a little bit more art. Again, if I miss your art, I just want to apologize. There is a very high probability I will miss your art, just considering how much art there is. And if the reason I haven't done all this yet is because there was just too much of it and I was too tired after streaming. So that's why I'm doing this now, like over a week later. From Dijani 10, Victory Turtle. From hang on. From Dr. Bleak, Bub Sauce 3D for charity. From Knox Robbins. Here's yeah. Larry Boy. Funny story about Larry Boy that I won't be telling you guys, but I do have a funny story. So you can look forward to that at some point. But yeah, this is really good art. Tell me, Sponge, do you pulp? From Lumpco. Some corruption art, I think. From Grump Wolf, here is some Street Fighter corruption art. It's like a Ryu singularity thing with like limbs from all directions. This actually happened, by the way. But yeah, that was a hell of a lot of fun. From Super Golden Nova, here's a Vine Shroom. From Azure Hue 22. Some charity stream shrooms. From Knox Robbins, there is King DDD, Bloodied. And again, if you missed it, it happened during the charity stream and it was fucking weird. From Alsatiable, there's more of the King. Surprising amount of Kirby art. Actually, you know what? No, Kirby deserves a lot of good art. From Cinepepper, all around me are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces. That fucking song. From Samio, here's a GIF that's not loading, actually. So I'm probably just going to have to do this, but it's a BRB GIF. Pretty cool. Almost a little bit video vine sauce plus corruptions in there. From Elusive Illustrator. Go vine sauce. From Dr. Tapeworm, Uncorruptible Dung. From Jewish Meatball, here's a GIF of, I think this was the Link to the Past stream. Link was acting kind of weird that day. From Putuk, here's another Bloody King DDD. I love the Bloody King DDDs. That was one of my favorite things ever. He was so weird. And it really looked like he was bloody and horrifying. Like it was one of those corruptions that there was no mistaking it for anything else. From Perbiwari? Or is it an L? I can't tell. Perbiwarl. Whoops. Victory Turtle. I don't even remember Victory Turtle, to be totally honest. Sorry to say. I might have to go back and refresh my memory. Nice art, though. From Sir Limes-a-Lot. Ray's Pastek. Okay. From Lizaroro. There's some Banjo-Kazooie corruption art. Still going. Like I said, there's quite a bit of art. From Knox Robbins, there's Grunty with Kermit in the pot. From Q-Burn, another bloody DDD. From Seijo Kaijin, good luck. Well, we did great, actually. Thank you for the wishes, the well wishes. But like I said, everyone, I just wanted to let you guys know we're all very proud of you. And even Critical, the YouTuber, contacted me and we've been talking a little bit. And he is very impressed with this community. And he's very, very, very happy with what we've done and what we've been able to raise for charity. So, you know, thank you guys for that. You impressed him as well. And that was really cool to hear from him. This is from Jewish Meatball. The Immortal Goomba from the Mario Corruptions. From Toast Logic, there's another DDD art. Someone in chat says, honestly, Vinny's standard voice sounds fairly similar to Critical. The thing about it is, he's got more inflection when you're just playing a game with him. But when he's doing his videos, he's a little bit more monotone, I think, on purpose. But yeah, we do have a slightly similar tone. I feel like he and I have similar styles. We like the same kind of shitty games. And I feel like we kind of both enjoy each other's content for a reason. And yeah, I guess maybe, like I said, he seems to be up for a stream. So maybe we'll see him around sometime. From Onion, more DDD art. From Ego 62, even more, but this is horrifying DDD. From Friendly Mushroom, this actually legitimately happened. Southbird actually is editing a highlights video of the best of the corruptions. I've seen an early draft of it. It's pretty good. I would say it actually covers all the moments very nicely. And so if you missed the charity stream corruptions and you want to just see the highlights, you can see them. And this will be in it, which was the South Park corruption. From Mind of Orangutan, that is the DDD that I was telling you about that was so fucking horrifying. From Jewish Meatball, what now? From Indy Angelo, Art of Me. From Rocket 333, there is some F-Zero art, which is just, in this case, there's just triangles. from Dope Fan. Amazing. Again, corruption art. From Pootuck. A lot of squeaking during that Banjo-Kazooie corruptions. From T-Owl. From Sheepsy. I must save Tootie. From Jewish Meatball again. But I'm the prettiest. I bet you are, Grunty. Compared to another witch of similar stature. I bet you are. From Aldben. Let's fuck Grunty. Oh, okay. That's a whole different thing. From Captain Palace. This is Animal Crossing corruption art. A little bit more. I think going back a little bit further, I see art for Gen Stream, which means I probably have finally made it through all of my art, or at least most of it. I know there's probably some other generic, like charity art. Like I'll find some of that real quick. And if I missed anything that you did and you're really, really proud of it and you want me to see it, just email it to me. I will not guarantee... Whoa, voice. It's late. I will not guarantee a response, but I will look at it. From Greth B. Donate for an awesome cause. Vegemite. He might eat more of me. Nope. Sorry. Never eating Vegemite again. Not even for charity. From Karaz Z. There's the banjo again. Let's see. From the Civ. Here was some more charity art. From Zebra RT. Vine Sauce Shroom. From Dr. Pretentious. There's a Dr. Vine Shroom. From Lizaroro, meanwhile at Verizon. Hey boss, our loyal customer at Vine Sauce is hosting a charity stream. Do not presume there will be a charity stream. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, sweet God. I have to say my internet's been fairly somewhat stable. Earlier today it was pretty bad, but during the charity stream it was at least stable, so thank God for that. From... the vine that grows limes. Here's like a kind of a Last Supper almost. And it's got all the streamers and stuff. Very cool. From McWhite Rose. From 8-Bit Beetle. I missed this one. This one's kind of awesome. Look at that. Almost a little bit of Animal Crossing feel to it. Oh, the logo specifically, but yeah, definitely Animal Crossing, actually, now that I look at it. And it is fantastic. I like how even Vappy and South Bird are represented. Mike is in the hole in the tree. So, yeah, a bunch of people are represented here, not just the main streamers. I like that. That's really good. Very, very nice piece of art. From Travis, I may have shown this at some point. Yes, I have. It's in my folder. From Tripsy Nostalgic Meme Spirits, Morty. And from RDNX. I don't remember the context of this at all. I have no idea what this has to do with anything ever. Or if it had anything to do with the charity stream to begin with. I'm just not sure. But it is kind of funny, so. More art from today. We're zooming back to today's art, so sorry to make you wait. Actually, not yet, we're not. Wait, yes, we are. Now we are. From Mick Birchman, you know, Changa, we'll be right back. from Cola Star. Here's some Metal Gear Solid 3 art. Bees, yeah, shoot the bees. Oh, that'll be great. From Cola Star. Snake, what happened? I killed them. I killed all of them. I had no choice. From Striding Crab, here's a vine shroom deep in the forest. See, this is cool because this is, in a weird way, this fits perfectly with the Metal Gear Solid theme. The Metal Gear Solid 3 theme, the forest, the jungle. It's like really good timing on this piece of art. I don't know if it had any influence from tonight's stream, but really, really nice. And also just a nice desktop background. From Bonus Pop. Vine Sauce with an S. Shovelware and bootleg. Cool. From, here's a GIF. So this isn't going to work. And yes, I still call it GIF. It's just force of habit and it sounds better anyway. GIF is a fucking peanut butter. A GIF is just what I'm used to calling moving images on the internet. But yeah, this is from Goddess. And it's tagged as glitches. But very cool. From Marugo, I Will Survive, Tamagotchi Life Resurrection. That's awesome. Wow, that's a really good piece of art for Sponge. That's like good promo art for the stream, too. By the way, Sunday, guys, this Sunday, we'll be doing some Tamagotchi, and it will be, it's not going to be a huge, huge, huge thing. You know, I'll be streaming Tamagotchi for a while, but we'll be checking in on all of the Islanders, and there will be a poll, and one Islander will be voted off, and it will be your fault. From Murugo, I Will Survive. Is that Vlinny? Yep, that's Vlinny. Oh, man. I could see this on the sides of buses. Like, to promote Tamagotchi Life Season 2. You know, like just have, like, some of the Islanders, the most popular Islanders, just on the side with I Will Survive. That is so perfect, Marugo. Really, really well done. I'll be using these as promotional pieces, by the way, so thank you for this. From Seamus Advais LT. Advais LT. It says, it's tagged as creepy, serious, soulless, and Toad. I don't know if Toad is all those things, or if the other things are the serious, creepy, and Toad's just there. But, yeah. From Gilded Mischief, here's a Solid Snake Vine Shroom. So, very cool, guys. Thank you so much for the art, and thank you for watching. I'll just go ahead and put this up. But this will be Sunday. I'm not sure what time, but just, you know how it is. Just check back. You'll usually find out what I'm up to just by checking in. Yeah, check out vinesauce.com if you want to see your streaming next. Dyer is actually streaming Fallout New Vegas right now, so you can go check him out. His Twitch name is just Direbore, so you can just do twitch.tv/Direbore. Or you can watch him on the site, your choice. GPM, are you still here? I know you mentioned last night you were streaming. I don't think GPM's here, actually. Let me see if GPM's streaming, because I haven't hosted him in a while. And he is good. I think Mike is still on vacation. Yeah, GPM is streaming. So I'll be hosting GPM. So you can check him out. He is a good friend of the stream for many years now. Really good streamer. And he's working on the Vine Sauce Repainted. And you should follow his channel, guys. If you really want to make him and me happy, when you go to his channel, it's just GEEPM. Just click follow, because it would make him really happy. It would make me really happy. And he's getting his Twitch presence kind of started, you know? So I really do like his streams a lot. And I'll just tell you this. When we do the Vine Sauce Games Repainted, he is spearheading it. And I'll be streaming the repainted, retextured Mario Galaxy. with him in a call with me. And then once I'm done the first stream of it, he's going to do the other streams of it. So definitely worth watching GPM. But all right, anyway, that's pretty much it. I will host. In other Vinny news, I just want to let you guys know that I am feeling a lot better today. I had a few moments where I was like, is this fucking thing ever going to end? But it feels like I'm finally like feeling much more myself. So I, you know, that's good. Advent Children, I'm still thinking about it. We finished Final Fantasy VII yesterday, and I'm thinking about ways to stream Advent Children. So I'll let you guys know about that. And I guess hopefully I'll be able to show you guys a brand new song that I've done on my own. I re-recorded some of the vocals at home. My microphone is not as good as what Joe has in the studio, but I have an MXL 770 for vocals. And I got to be honest, with the right kind of effects, like the right filters and EQing, it sounds really good. In fact, it just sounds good on its own. It's a really decent vocal microphone for its cost. So I will have yet another new song for you guys. And this one is going to be super catchy, but also really kind of cool. It's got some good guitar tones. But other than that, I think that's all I got for you guys. Just thanks for watching. You know, thanks for being around. It's a really impressive turnout tonight. We had 2,300 people watching at like fucking 2 a.m. And that's just insanely good. And I just thank you guys for caring. Thank you guys for watching. And thanks for being you. It's been, you know, always great. And I was feeling a little bit down in the dumps because of me being sick. But it's funny because as soon as I start getting back into streaming, I feel good again. It's great. So just thanks for that. And yeah, that's all I got. I'll see you soon, guys. Good night. And enjoy GPM stream. He's streaming Oblivion. Later, guys.